And then I think those aliens would be even more sad than us. Further up in the food chain, more time to sit around and think about things, probably more depressed. I realize depression is not a real dynamite topic for a comedy show. But I also don't know where else we're really talking about. It seems like a subject that should be addressed. I mean, we've kind of, you know, with everything that's going on just in society, it seems like an epidemic, and particularly the military. It seems like something we maybe should address. And we've kind of tried, just on some level, if anything, we've kind of changed the language a little bit. You hear things now more commonly like, she was just too weak to ask for help. He wasn't strong enough to ask for help. Like, what are we doing? Now we're making people feel even worse? That makes no sense. And that logic of associating strength with asking for help makes no sense to me. Like, oh yeah, me and Carl going across the train tracks the other day, Carl kind of stalled a little bit, him shrieking for help immediately, tough son of a bitch. That makes no sense. Why is there such a premium on being tough? You don't have to be fucking tough all the time. If you're hanging from a cliff by one arm and you ask for help, that doesn't make you the toughest individual that ever lived. But it is the appropriate thing to do in that situation. It's the smart thing. We should encourage that. Like, oh yeah, don't hang there like a lunatic. Like, nope, everything's fine. Everything's just fine. Move along. I live on this cliff. Everything's fine. No, ask for help. I mean, tough people didn't ask for help, and they typically don't live that long. When you think of the toughest people that ever lived, pioneers, settlers, people had to scratch and claw for every inch they got on this planet, you typically don't think of them living very long. You definitely don't think of them asking for help, just like, well, the mine collapsed and a beam fell on my shoulder and busted it up pretty good, but I held it up long enough for Johnson to come crawling out of there, and then the whole thing collapsed and caved in and shattered the left side of my body. But I dragged myself back to camp arm over arm before the pain got too bad and I passed out, and do people think about me when I'm not around? Does anyone really love me, or is that just a hollow phrase we've been trained to say to one another to make it feel less empty inside? And why am I down in the mine in the first place? I'm down there chipping at rocks so rich people can wear metal around their necks. Who gives a shit about that? I hate the mine. Why am I in the mine in the first place? Is it just because I got to have a job? Because everyone's got to have a job, but we really have no clue why we're here in the first place? I hate the mine. If it weren't for the mine, I'd be down dancing naked through waterfalls or running through a meadow, but I can't because the mine. Truth be told, if there were no mine, I wouldn't be in the meadow and I wouldn't be in the waterfall because I'm a coward at heart. I'm afraid to follow my dreams. Y'all ever seen a dinosaur bone? They're pretty old, ain't they? Yeah, that guy had his own hopes and dreams too, and now all that's left of him, just a little bit of piece of bone, millions of years old. His life was just a blink of an eye, so what's mine gonna matter? And I miss being a little boy. So, that never happened, but that guy would have lived forever.